I'm Erica. I'm from Flint, Michigan. I'm representing Michigan in the Hooters International Swimsuit Pageant.
Hey, Vitas, welcome back to La Vida Al Vita. Today, I'm going to show you guys a behind the scenes look on how I created and constructed a hometown pageant costume for no other than Miss Michigan, Erica. She is competing in the Miss International Swimsuit Pageant, and she decided to use moi as her creator and her fashionista for her hometown costume. The costume is very much inspired by Michigan, and you'll see exactly what I mean when you see the rest of the video. She was an amazing girl to work with. She was very inspirational and just a great muse to work off of. So I'm gonna show you guys everything from start to finish. The sketching of the costume, the construction of the costume, even behind the scenes fitting in Las Vegas for the costume, and of course, the finalized piece. So I'm very excited for you guys to see the whole process. I hope you guys are inspired by what you see, and maybe you can learn a little something from what you see as well. So without further ado, let's go behind the scenes. So the first step in any design is to create the actual sketch to work off of. Once we developed the concept of what we wanted to do, I was able to go ahead and sketch the ideas that both Erica and I came up with for a very unique, one-of-a-kind costume for her to wear. This whole process took me back to when I used to do fashion design. It was so therapeutic to get back into doing fashion illustration, which was one of my most favorite things to do. So here's the finalized sketch. Now it's time to render it in Photoshop. So back in the day, I used to do all my fashion illustrations using Prisma markers, but with the way technology has advanced, I've been starting to do all of my illustrations in Photoshop. So as you can see here, I'm using all the required tools that I need to create the same type of fashion illustration effect that I would get with markers, but done on the computer digitally. So it's a lot easier for me to convert to JPEGs and use them for different files and to send to people a lot easier than having just used a regular pen, paper, and marker sketch. One of the reasons I really enjoy doing Photoshop renderings is because if you make a mistake, you can always fix it. When you usually do anything with marker or pencils, if you make the mistake, it's really hard to go back and cover it up, which is why I enjoy Photoshop rendering so much. It also allows you to be able to take images and blend them in together to make your illustration look a lot more realistic and a lot more professional. This is just how I love to do it because it just adds so much more detail to your image. So since Erica and I live in different states, it was very important that I got her measurements correct. So I had her send me one of her actual bras so I could fit it on my mannequin to make sure that all my measurements were done correctly for the fitted corset. It was very important that I got her measurements correct since I couldn't have her for fittings all the time. So having her bra was very convenient for my draping and fitting. So now that I was able to drape all the needed shapes that I need, my next step is to make sure that all the patterns are cut out based off of what design I came up with on the mannequin. So that is what you see me doing here. The next important step is to make sure that all my cut pieces are interfaced. The reason why I need everything to be interfaced is because when making a corset, it is very important that the corset holds its shape and that it's durable enough that when it is on a person, that it holds everything in place like a corset should do. So thus, interfacing each individualized fabric before it is sewn together is vital for any corset construction. So this is a two-step process. Now that I have my muslin pieces cut out and interfaced, my next step is to go ahead and take my red jersey fabric and do the exact same thing. But my first step now is to cut out the exact same patterns that I had the muslin pieces onto my red jersey knit. Once that is done, I'm going to go ahead and reinforce the red jersey knit the exact same way I did the muslin. This is going to allow for double firmness when creating my corset. So once those two layers are done, I'm combining them together to make sure that my corset is nice and durable. So now that all my pieces are cut and reinforced, my next step is to begin sewing the pieces together. Once certain pieces are sewn together, I'm going to take it back to the mannequin and begin to drape it again just to make sure that everything is sewn and starting to fit properly. If I see anything that's not fitting properly, this is where I go and I readjust and pin properly to how it needs to fit and continue sewing after. So as you saw, I pinned and made all the proper adjustments that I needed to make. Once I did that, now it's time to go back and sew all the pieces together to create my fitted corset shape. And once that's done, I do final draping adjustments just to make sure and verify that every seam is properly in place and sewn correctly. So now that my sewing is done, my next step is to start to add the boning. So I'm going to go on the inside part of the corset and iron down the seams so I can add the boning in between them. Once that's done, I'm going to take the boning, cut it into the standard sizes that I need, and then I'm going to tape them down and sew them into place. And for those of you who don't know what boning are those firm strips that line each seam in a corset that basically hold the shape of the corset. Aside from the interfacing, boning is one of the most important things when constructing a corset. The boning needs to be in its proper place along the seams and it needs to be sewn to make sure that everything is held in place. Once that's done, my next step is to finish off the raw seams on the top and bottom part of the corset so that everything is finished properly, which is what you see me doing here. That's the last step for the construction of the corset before I start to add all of the extra details. Once everything is sewn and ready to go on the corset, my next step is to create the lacing in the back. This is the portion of the corset where you can adjust the fit to make sure that it fits your client perfectly. So I'm using a ribbon that I bought from Joann Fabrics that resembles shoelace because I want to have that sporty look to it. And I'm hand sewing each loop, three on each side individually, and then taking the remainder of that shoelace material and using it for the lace up in the back. Now that the corset and the lacing is complete, my next step is to hand paint a Red Wings and Hooter combination logo that I created for Erica. It was required for her to have the Hooters logo represented in the costume. It was very important that it be shown, and my only option in a creative way was to just paint it on myself. I didn't want to do any iron-ons, and I didn't want to have to take it to somebody else to have it silkscreened. I figured having it artistically painted on would be more of an interesting feature and it'd put more of my actual touches onto the piece. So just like my fashion illustration, this brought me back. I haven't picked up a paintbrush in so long, so it was actually very therapeutic to get back into my painting state. It's been so long since I painted anything, so this was actually really enjoyable for me to do. So this part was quite fun because it's all the bedazzling, which just adds that extra spark to the outfit, especially for a pageant. You always want to make sure that when you're creating a pageant outfit that that girl is going to stand out on stage. So bedazzling is always a great option to make sure that she shines and glitters on stage with all the lights reflecting off of her. So one of my last steps before heading to Vegas to fit Erica was to create her thigh highs and arm sleeves to really pull together the whole entire outfit to show everyone how it was inspired by the Detroit Red Wings. This involved taking my red jersey fabric as well as my white jersey fabric and sewing them together with the white as a strip between the two to really pull together that Detroit Red Wings look.
Competed against other girls that she's made costumes for pageants, and they were unbelievable, so I just had to have her. I wanted to choose something that was recognizable, that other people would know, you know, all that girl's from Michigan. Detroit is our most popular city, and I wanted to choose something that represented Detroit well, and that is the Red Wings. I love it. I love the way it fits. I love the style of it. The colors are awesome on me. It looks really good. I love it. It was awesome. She went above and beyond to do everything, to make everything so easy for me, and she really wanted to, it was important to her, for her to make me the costume like that I wanted. It wasn't about what she thought, it was about what I thought, so it was awesome.
So there you have it, Vidas, a behind-the-scenes look on creating a hometown-inspired pageant costume. I hope you guys enjoyed what you saw, and I will see you back here for some more videos.